Recently, Alibaba's Pi team released the ControlNet 2.0 version of Zimage Turbo. What exactly are the improvements in version 2.0 compared to version 1.0? In this video, we will explain this using two key points. The first is to show you exactly what improvements version 2.0 has over version 1.0. The second is to summarize some practical techniques when using version 2.0. I have also built a workflow on Running Hub. You can access this platform through Running Hub. In the field of ComfUI, Running Hub is an excellent online workbench because whenever new models or new technologies appear, they follow up immediately. You can register for Running Hub using the invitation link in my video description. This way, you can receive 1,000 free points. Additionally, you will receive 100 points every day you log into Running Hub. This allows you to try out your own workflows. Next, let's address the first question. What are the improvements of ControlNet 2.0 compared to 1.0? We can see some information on its GitHub page, of course. Some of this information is academic, covering overall optimization layers as well as training steps, and even improvements in the learning rate, it provides explanations for these. However, these details are not very intuitive for us. To give everyone a clear understanding of this improvement and distinction, let's look at a concrete example. Take a look. This is a ControlNet 1.0 workflow. Let's briefly review it here. I have loaded the main model of Zimage Turbo. Then, I loaded a LoRA that I trained myself, mainly to maintain character consistency. You can use this or not. I adjusted the CFG value here to 3.0. And here, I loaded the ControlNet 1.0 version. Then we have a reference image here. We have used this before. This is a 3D model showing a character preparing for a fight below. I used DW OpenPose to extract the posture and scaled it to a 1K resolution. Look at the result. Because it is DW OpenPose, it includes both facial information and hand information. The key node we used here is this one. This node allows us to apply our ControlNet information to our main model. First, we connect the Zimage Turbo main model to the model input. Then, we connect the loaded ControlNet to the model patch input. Our image is actually the generated pose image below. The prompt is quite simple. A Western female warrior standing on a vertical megalith. Around her is a continuous sea of clouds, and she has a red cloak and a fighting posture. Regarding its sampling, we have explained before that. The sampling mode of Zimage Turbo is quite similar to VA 2.2. This is the sampling for the high noise model, and this is the sampling for the low noise model. This one is mainly responsible for composition, and this one is mainly responsible for refinement. Similarly, our total sampling steps are 8 steps. The first 4 steps are responsible for composition, and the last 4 steps are responsible for refinement. The specific sampling parameters are conventional. You can check them yourselves. Now let's look at the generated result. Comparing it with the pose image, take a look. The overall consistency is very strong. Now let's look at the performance of ControlNet 2.0. The overall workflow is exactly the same. We simply switch the model from 1.0 to 2.0. The remaining prompts, parameters, and the overall structure of the workflow are completely consistent. Now let's look at the generated result. Let's compare it with the pose image. Take a look. This result is also fine. If you only look at the comparison of these two workflows, you actually can't tell the difference. Of course, I think there are many differences, but we can't show them all. Let's demonstrate one of them. Pay attention. Currently, this is the 1.0 version workflow. Now, we will lower the weight of this control net. I will lower it to 0.75. Now, let's sample and generate. Now we have a result. Let's generate it again. Look at this result. I will generate it again. Now we have generated 3 images. Look, these are 3 images generated under a weight of 0.75. Compare these 3 images. They actually have no relation. The concept of pose similarity is irrelevant. These poses have no correlation whatsoever. Therefore, we can conclude that ControlNet 1.0 does not have an intermediate state. Now I will change it to 0.5 and generate again. Take a look. Let's generate one more. We'll generate 2 now. Take a look. This kind of consistency is also absent. So you will find that regardless of whether the strength is 0.75 or 0.5, We cannot clearly sense the existence of pose consistency. Regarding the same issue, let's look at the performance of 2.0. Notice I am changing the weight to 0.75 now. Then, let's run it once. Take a look. The consistency still exists. Let's run it again. Take a look. Run it again. The basic action is consistent. One more time. We ran about 4 images. These 4 images are basically consistent. Now, let's change the weight to 0.5. Take a look. The overall form and the facial orientation are still consistent, but the hand pose has changed. Let's run it again. Okay, this is getting a bit too much, right? 0.5 one more time. Take a look. Run another one. You can see that these are images I generated in real time without generating them beforehand. You will find that the intermediate state of 2.0 is clearer. From this perspective, the improvement of ControlNet 2.0 relative to 1.0 is quite significant. Next, let's talk about some practical techniques for 2.0. First, you need to be clear on how to use Z-Image Turbo ControlNet 2.0. You need to update your ComfyUI to the latest version. We can click on its commit list. You can see this information. It currently supports the ControlNet 2.0 version. Let's go back and look at the Z-Image Turbo ControlNet official website on Hugging Face. One feature mentioned here is very important. It is called Pose Plus InPaint. This means it has both pose control and in-painting functionality. But why didn't I demonstrate it? Currently, this feature has not been implemented in the official ComfyUI. So if you are attempting this feature, stop for now. It cannot be implemented yet. Let's look at the commit information. There is a string of numbers. If we click on it, there's a very clear explanation here. We have not implemented the InPaint function yet. It will be added later. So everyone needs to pay attention to this point. Although this function could be called the biggest improvement of 2.0 relative to 1.0, unfortunately, it is not currently implemented. Next, let's look at some other statements. The supported ControlNet types have not changed much. It is still the common ones. Additionally, there is a very important piece of information mentioned. Regarding this ControlNet, the recommended weight is 0.65, 0.9. Oh, furthermore, there is a piece of bold text here stating that if you increase this weight, you should try to correspondingly increase the sampling steps. To make it visually clearer, there is a table below. Let's look. When your strength is 0.65, it suggests 9 sampling steps. If it is 0.70, then 10 sampling steps are needed. Following this progression, 0.75 requires 20 steps. If you set it to 1.0, it suggests 40 sampling steps. This is also a small tip. Let's test this out for everyone first. This is the 2.0 version workflow. Now, I will change this to 1.0, then I will change the sampling steps to 40. Similarly, the first 20 steps are for composition, and the next 20 steps are for refinement. Let's run it once so everyone can gauge it. Now, the sampling is complete. Let's take a look. First, the character's pose is indeed more accurate. However, the character is somewhat overexposed and there is some artifacting. Therefore, we can appropriately increase the sampling steps, but not too high. You can use 20 steps, the first 10 steps for composition and the last 10 steps for refinement. Take a look. I think this is fine. So, wanting to increase the steps appropriately is acceptable, but not infinitely increasing them to 40 steps, as the official website suggests. This is because the implementation method in ComfyUI is different from the original program. I think the generated content is also fine when we use a strategy of 8 to 10 steps. Take a look, I think this result is good enough. If you feel you need more detail or feel the pose alignment is not sufficient, you can try increasing the steps. These are some application techniques. Through my demonstration, I hope everyone understands the improvements of 2.0 compared to 1.0, because 2.0 was released so quickly after 1.0. 1.0 must have had some fatal flaws. This fatal flaw is what we demonstrated. The lack of consistency maintenance in the intermediate state. This was very poor. Of course, there might be many other improvements that I haven't tested. Everyone can try them out themselves. Okay, that's all for today. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.